Recently, XP Pen sent me their new tablet to test out, the Magic Drawing Pad. It's a standalone tablet that runs the Android OS. The idea is that you can take it with you and do your creative work on the go. So I decided to test it by taking it with me on a trip to the Ghibli Museum in Tokyo. I got on the high-speed train and tried my hand at some 3D sculpting. Unfortunately, Blender doesn't run on Android. However, there's a great app that you can use for free, to some extent, and that's Nomad Sculpt. It runs on iOS and Android as well. There are several matte gaps that you can choose from, just like in Blender, and you can choose between a Miltres, Voxel or DinTopo workflow. By default in Nomad Sculpt you start with a sphere, and you can turn the symmetry on or off. If you already sculpt in Blender, the interface of Nomad Sculpt will feel very familiar. The only thing I personally had to get used to is that you need to do everything with the pen. And usually, for example, I set the brush radius with a keyboard shortcut. But after a while, you just get used to it. The brushes are the same ones that you know from all sculpting packages. Drag, move, smooth, flatten, inflate, mask, and all those usual ones. To add more objects, you click on Add and choose a primitive. Then you can use the gizmo to transform it. Be sure to turn on Mirror if the object needs to be mirrored, for example like arms or legs. And then when you want to sculpt on it, you have to click on Validate. This part here is like the outliner in Blender, where you can select which object to work on. After that, you just select the brush you want to use, and then you get to work. I recommend giving Nomad Sculpt a try if you enjoy 3D sculpting. It was very inspiring to visit the Ghibli Museum. If you have a chance to visit, I really recommend it for recharging your creative batteries. Among other things, I watched Miyazaki's amazing 3D animated short, Borrow the Caterpillar. Truly the best example of non-photoreal rendering I've seen yet. On the roof, everybody took photos with the robot from Castle in the Sky. I used the tablet for quite some time, both to learn Nomad Sculpt and as a regular tablet, for reading ebooks and watching YouTube videos. It comes with several spare nibs for the pen, as well as the pen itself, of course. There's also a USB-C cable and a charger, and one of those cool gloves that make you look really professional. Overall, I thought it's a nice tablet that's lightweight but still big enough, so you really can use it while on the go for drawing and sculpting. It ran Nomad Sculpt smoothly without any issues. Just like the XP Pen tablet that I reviewed before, they boast 16K pen pressure sensitivity. I will mention that while Nomad Sculpt is free, I did find out after finishing my tutorial of NSculpt that you need to buy it in order to export the file. So if you want to refine or render your sculpt in Blender, then you will need to pay. But if you just want to practice sculpting, you can just use the free version. If you have any questions about the tablet, feel free to ask them in the comments. Thanks for watching and happy sculpting!